Banita Home,
Holy Center,
Homeless Home,
Tonela Maji,
Families to Families,
Koinonia Rescue Center.
We start the rescue during the month of January up to the month of April, and in the course of the 3 months, it's whereby we try to connect with these kids that we find in the street. In the first place, it's hard to identify with them because you really don't know who you're meeting, a stranger for the first time, so you don't know who you are meeting. But as time goes, we try to connect with them. We work during the night because it's the time that you can find all the street boys together and also the street girls together. Food is everything to everybody. It brings a close connection. And also we play games with them, football, rugby, so that we can try to connect more. And then it's during the street that we try like to start asking, where did you come from? Where is your home? Why are you in the street? Like, we start like understanding, who are these kids? Who are they? Like, who are they, like, individually? The day that now we need to bring these children to become part and parcel of Koinonia Community, a bus is provided whereby we go to the various bases that we have connected with those the kids that we have connected with, the kids that are willing to be part of us. We go and pick them up. And like I said from the beginning, it's a process. So when we go for them, they are usually very aware and very ready, energetic to be part and parcel of Koinonia. And then after that, we go to a field. It can be in Ngong. We play football together. We eat lunch together. And then after that, we take them for a camping. This camping is it's generally to make them understand that now they are changing. Now their life is going to be different. They are moving from the life that is there in the street, and now they are going to join a new life that will be joyous and will also be good for them. During that night, you find that the boys, they are so open. They want to share their stories. They want this new change. They are so excited about the change that is going to happen to them. So we take supper together, and then in the morning, the bus comes for us, and so we go to the center.
Kivuli Center itself is known to be a rehabilitation center for the former street children. For us, the biggest success is that period that you've seen that I did rescue this child indeed. There was need for protection, and the successful protection has been done. The child was in need of education. The successful part of education has been done. The successful again is in the talent of every given child. That when you've seen that the child has made it in talents and could also be able to settle in talents and for the future earning, that is also a success. And I believe Kivuli, since its initiation, have had a lot of successful story, because this institution has produced, we produce bankers, we produce engineers. In Kivuli, we produce clinicians. And all these are success that can be counted for the institution.
Our main mandate is providing therapy services to children living with disability in Kibera and surrounding areas. Our activities include therapy services. We have physiotherapy and occupational therapy and speech therapy. We provide medical support for our children. We provide educational support where we train the teachers in the schools that our kids are integrated in. We also provide some educational support in terms of school fees or uniforms, among other needs associated with education. We also do medical support because, as you know, many of our kids with special needs have other medical issues.
We do follow up for our children, those who are in the daycare, and also those who are in the outpatient program, and also those who are in the outreach program.
We have special needs education, we have early childhood education, we have group learning, we have group therapy, we have the individual sessions, we have social skills, like we do play and therapy, we do inclusion and integration.
Another challenge, integrating the children to other schools,
yeah.
You find the teachers are not accepting these kids because some of them, they don't have the knowledge how to handle these kids.
Once the girl is admitted in a Anita home, she goes through psychosocial support. They also get life skills whereby it goes down to realizing their fullest potential. And also they are taken through talent development. Every Tuesday we have cultural dances. Recently they also performed at the International Trade Fair, whereby the acrobatic team was the second runners up in the country. And also we get the girls get education whereby they attend to the local primary school. It's government, it's called Ololo Primary. But we have three sponsored in Greenyard Primary School. So those ones are taken through up to standard 8. We are doing something for the family empowerment because the girl won't stay in Anita forever. They'll have to complete the cycle and then they go back to their family. So by the family, will be able to provide for them. The thing that we hold proud is that the girl child, even if previously it was seen that the girls relapse, this now we can say that we have at least many girls who have gone through the program, like the one I mentioned earlier who's doing her medicine in Tanzania and the one who's already in Chuka University. So we can say that it is a great achievement that the girl child has left the taboo that it used to be the girl is not for the bigger things.
What we normally do after we have rescued these children, we normally put them on course to make sure that they are detached from the drugs and even the cultural behaviors that they normally push them to the street, which means we have to make sure that they are drained from all those bad cultures and behaviors. We normally also do what we call accelerated learning to our beneficiaries, and currently we have 21 beneficiaries. We have 4 that are in secondary school, and the rest are just schooling around here in our local public schools. We normally give them what we call psychosocial support. We also invite counselors to come on board to assist them understand their problems better and even try to bridge the differences between them and their families. What we normally appeal is to the friends of Tonela Maji, so that they can also come on board, do some kind of well-wishing and voluntary measures. Our greatest achievement is that we've been able to transform the lives of several children, those who are on the street, and right now they're in sound mind, they're thinking straight, and they have achieved a lot in their lives. We have seen a drastic change, a positive change, because now they don't take drugs again. They've been accepted in the family setup.
The integration is a process, it's not one day thing. The family comes to take the child while we go together with them back home and make sure everything is okay to assure the child that she or he is a safe place and we are together. We also provide support such as basic needs like mattress and a blanket, food for some few days or weeks, so the family could have that great time together.
I came to Anita in 1999. We were one of the first girls to come in Anita. It became our home. Mm-hmm. At least for some of us whom we didn't have someone to call daddy, we didn't have someone to call mommy. Here we had mommy, we had daddy, we had uncles, aunties, and it was a nice family.
Tunatanga sana kwa sababu walikuwa wanatuchukulia kama watoto wao. Hawajawahi kupesa in any way. Tulikuwa tunakaa tu as a family. Tunashukuru sababu hapa ni home. Hata nikikuja na feeling tu nikiwa home.
I got many things that many people that have their parents have never got what I got from here. We had no stress. We felt at home. Everything we wanted, kila kitu, from dressing, hair, shoes, everything.
Walitutoa bali yenyewe.
I give that to my father Kizito. But Kizito has always been my dad till now. I've always living knowing that he's my dad because he took good care of me. To appreciate all that he has done to us, and his name will always run in my family.
Enye Mungu abariki Koinonia Community na pia wenye wote madonors kwa sababu wenye tumetoka far. Na saizi mali tumefika hapa, kama si wao wenye tumekuwa mahali.